That's not a crossbow. That's a crossbow. Wait, didn't I already make that joke? Hello everyone and welcome. Today we beat Elden Ring with an ordinary crossbow. A few people commented on my pirate video saying I should have given her an eye patch, and you're right. So to make up for it, I'm making sure this sharpshooter has the right eyewear. A blindfold. First things first, I ride around collecting seeds and tears, then I decided to grab Radagon's sore seal, but now I know why it's called a sore seal. Next, I need to get my weapon. Over in Weeping Peninsula, this merchant sells the light crossbow. Fantastic! Only problem, it's not my crossbow. See, this crossbow is too good. The game would be an absolute cakewalk with it, so instead, I want the soldier's crossbow. According to the wiki, the best place to farm it is from these 2-foot soldiers, but after 50 or so attempts of it not dropping, I started to get angry, saying to myself, the wiki is wrong, that stupid crossbow isn't here, and you're literally holding the crossbow, please give it to me. But they never dropped it. After what felt like an eternity of farming these guys, I was defeated, so I decided to order my comfort food, McDonald's. But that's when I saw it. An ad for a crossbow, and I knew my computer was listening to me. So, I did the only reasonable thing someone should do when they suspect a privacy invasion. I hired a man to stand in my apartment screaming things 24/7 to confuse the ad companies. At first, he said nonsensical things like, bananas are purple, and Australia's a real place. But after a while, he said something that made crystal clear sense. If you really want to protect your online privacy, you should check out today's sponsor, NordVPN. Nord offers a safe and secure way for you to browse the internet so you never have to worry about someone stealing your information. They even offer double VPN to keep you doubly safe, but hey, maybe you have nothing to hide and instead are just mad that your favorite show isn't streamable where you live. I know the feeling, the lands betweens options are pretty sparse. Well, Nord's got you covered there too. With over 5,300 servers across 60 different countries, you'll never miss out on your favorite show ever again. One of my favorite things about their service is just how easy it is to use. You literally launch the app, click on a server, and bam, your computer thinks it's on the other side of the world. You'd think having to jump between so many connections it would drastically cut down your internet speed, but nope, Nord's connection is equally fast as it is secure. I've personally been using NordVPN for several years, so I was thrilled when they reached out to me because now I can share it with all of you. Use my link in the description or go to nordvpn.com/doomwolf to get a great deal, and the best part? It's all risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. A big thank you to Nord for sponsoring this video, now back to our regularly scheduled programming. What was I doing again? Oh yeah, the crossbow. After forever, it finally dropped, and some pants, so in other words, I now have my in-game weapon and armor. No doctor, I have no idea why I have a headache. In Kaelid, I pick up the arrow sting talisman, a staple that I'll use the entire run. I'll talk more about talismans a little later, but just know, they all kind of suck. I'm feeling a little confident, so I think it's time to take on Margit with my completely unupgraded soldier's crossbow. And one stack of bolts. Because that's a good idea. 45 damage. I can't believe Fromm would leave such a broken weapon in the game. This is ridiculous. Headshots do a little more damage, but to land them you have to free aim, and most enemies react to the crossbow being fired, usually meaning they will shift their hurtbox enough to whiff the shot, and no damage is definitely worse than some damage. So, for most of this run, you won't see me going for headshots. Slowly, and I do mean slowly, I chip Margit down until the fight ends and I have a whopping 2 bolts left. So yeah, I'm pretty optimistic about this run. Originally, I had planned to go straight to Godric, but I think it would be smarter to upgrade my weapon first, so I head over to the Rhea Lucaria tunnels and take on the Crystallion. For those of you that don't know, crossbows don't scale with your stats. Like, at all. So the only way to get more damage out of them is to upgrade them, which is exactly why I need your stone, Mr. Crystallion, so please give it to me. Well, this is both embarrassing and demoralizing. Fortunately, on the second try, he goes down. I bring my crossbow up to a +7, grab the arrow's reach talisman, buy some flaming bolts for backup, then take on the Lord of all that's golden. 125. That's almost 3 times as much damage as I was doing to Margit, but his health bar moved about the same amount. I think I rest my case why no one should ever do this run. Fortunately, Godric is an incredibly easy boss and he goes down on the first try. It's at this point I realized I was still at rune level 1, but like I said, stats don't matter at all, so I'm just gonna dump everything into vigor. Since I can't increase my damage through leveling, the next best thing is to just have a stockpile of as many bolts as I can. Fortunately, there's a wide variety of them. Rot bolts, poison bolts, sleep bolts. I won't be using any of those because you have to craft them, but there are still half a dozen that you can buy from merchants. However, that's for later me to worry about. Now me wants to defeat the Warmaster Shackbell Bearing Hunter who, apparently has a phobia of using the front door? Range characters are apparently so toxic he wanted to contemplate life. Me too, buddy. With him down, I can now buy thin beast bones, allowing me to craft bone bolts. They aren't particularly strong, but having 99 extra toothpicks will always be welcome. Next, I make my way through Liurnia to the academy. This is why I don't do no death runs. Red Wolf of Radagon. Remember what I said about enemies reacting to the crossbow being fired? Yeah, that, but worse. This doggo destroys the whole debate parlor trying to avoid my shots, but you can't run from fate and eventually he goes down. Next up is Renala. Phase 1 is never a problem, even less so this time around because I can snipe the sweetings with the shields, then just stand in front of her unloading into her face. Phase 2 is, honestly just kind of boring. Since we're both ranged fighters, I spend the whole time just circling taking shots between dodging her magic attacks. One good thing I haven't mentioned about the crossbow is you actually don't have to reload it directly after firing. Meaning, it's actually a really safe way to fight. That's pretty much the only good thing about it, but hey, credit where credit is due. Never get greedy when the Bloodhound Knight is summoned. Who am I kidding, greedy? She's still like 10 shots away from going down, at least. Whatever, next attempt, we stand victorious over the Queen of the Full Moon. With her down, I can access Altus Plateau. Well, okay, she isn't actually a requirement to get here, but I like to follow a normal progression so I'm not overpowered for the early game. Anyway, I get the next bell bearing from the sealed tunnel, bring my crossbow to a plus 12, grab the ritual sword talisman, have Raya take me to Volcano Manor because I'm too lazy to walk, and last but certainly not least, die to this man 3 times. In doing so, I am now able to access Moog, but more importantly, I can go bird hunting. Or I guess gravity can go bird hunting, I just get the assist. Every kill nets me a cool 11,000 runes, but I can already hear you typing now, dear viewer, how dare you farm levels in a challenge run Doom? To which I say, don't worry, dear viewer, I'm only destroying the Lands Between's economy because I'm going shopping. After farming an easy 650,000 runes, I buy a full stock worth of flaming, regular, lightning, golden, explosive, meteor, and bird bolts. Just to be completely clear, I did not farm any runes to level up. Even if I did, it's pointless because no stats outside of vigor matter, and the main bosses will allow me to level that. Next, I set this Erdtree Avatar on fire for... That isn't a lot of damage. What about normal bolts? Oh, they do exactly the same amount of damage. Cool. Yeah, so I quickly learned that because of the low base damage of the crossbow and the split damage of the individual bolts, specialized ones such as the flaming bolt aren't ever really going to outperform regular ones, even when the boss takes 40% increased fire damage. In fact, most of them will do less than normal because practically every boss resists various elemental types. In other words, I'm basically sitting on 1,000 normal bolts per encounter. More than enough to handle any boss, but definitely kinda boring. Anyway, I decided to grab the Blue Dancer Charm to boost what little damage I could, then take on the Draconic Tree Sentinel. He's not hard, there's ample times to weave attacks in between his fire and lightning casts, and anytime he runs at me, I just run past him. The only damage I took in this whole fight was when I accidentally backrolled into his fireball. He goes down on the first attempt. Let that be a warning to you, Mr. Dragon. I wouldn't want to fight me. Goldfree, my old friend, how's the wife? Ooh, sorry about that. How is it that you're a ghost, but I can still shoot you with bolts? I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm glad you aren't immune to everything but special ghost attacks, but it's kind of ridiculous. Oh well, it was nice seeing you, Goldfree. I'm sure we'll catch up again soon. With the fourth and final talisman slot unlocked, it's finally time to talk about this build. There isn't one. My goal with the Ordinary Weapon series is to take a common but underused weapon and turn it into a force of destruction. But you can't really do that with a crossbow. You might be able to do some semblance of normal damage with the pulley crossbow because it fires 3 arrows at once, or maybe even the full moon crossbow, I haven't actually tried it, but you absolutely cannot do it with the regular soldier's crossbow. Normally, if a weapon has suboptimal damage, you can supplement it with a talisman, but there aren't really any for crossbows. In fact, there are only 2 talismans that are specific to bows and crossbows, Arrow Sting and Arrow's Reach, which increase damage and range respectively. Increased range might make you feel cool because you can snipe things from further away, but the sad truth is that there's only a couple of boss arenas in the whole game that could actually make use of the added distance, so it's kinda worthless. Extra damage will always be welcome, but the problem here is, it's percent based. On paper, a 10% increase to arrows and bolts sounds great, but then you remember the crossbow hits for like sub 300 maxed out and realize, it's kinda trash. Other than that, there are only 6 talismans that could indirectly benefit this build. The Ritual Sword Talisman, the Blue Dancer Charm, the Red Feathered Branch Sword, the Kindreds of Rot and Lords of Blood Exaltation, and the Spear Talisman. Since the crossbow allows us to stay at range, the ritual sword talisman makes sense. Even though it's only another 10%, we aren't ever really in danger of being hit. In theory, the red feathered branch sword is the same, but trying to hypermode a crossbow is just pointless. The extra damage would be so small, it's just smarter to stay at full health. The blue dancer charm is useful to me because I specifically decided not to wear any heavy armor in this run, but it would be worthless to anyone playing normally because, and say it with me everyone, the percent damage increase on crossbows suck. The two exaltation talismans would boost your attack by 20%, but the problem here is twofold. One, the crossbow doesn't attack fast enough to apply a status more than like two times in a fight, and two, because of the same low firing rate, you don't really get to fully utilize the increased attack power. To be fair, the pulley crossbow might be able to do something with these talismans, seeing that it can, in theory, apply damage and statuses three times faster, but we're not using the pulley crossbow. Lastly, there is the spear talisman, which is kind of weird. This thing basically increases the damage unique to thrusting weapons while the enemy is attacking. So basically, you do increased counterattack damage. But it also works for arrows and bolts. I don't really know why it works with arrows and bolts, but I'll take what I can get. There are a couple of boss attacks I'll be able to exploit with this, but it more or less will just provide an inconsistent damage increase. All of this is to tell you that as much as I would have loved to turn the soldier's crossbow into a weapon that can melt bosses from across the game, you can't. Crossbows were never meant to be a primary damage dealer. They work fantastic as an easy way to get an enemy's attention, and that's all they should ever be used for. Oh well, with my build completed, it's time to take on Morgott. He actually has zero resistance to fire in phase 1 and a weakness to lightning in phase 2 because of the rain. Like I said earlier, the special bolts probably won't be doing any more damage than the regular ones, but hey, I've got the bird's money, so who cares, and he goes down on the first try. Up next is the fire giant, a boss I was worried about because of his large health pool, a sentiment that will be echoed later, but bird bolts hard carry this fight. I had originally thought phase 2 would be annoying with the weak spots being on his arms now, but then we kind of just played ring around the rosy with his rock and one of us has a devastating ranged attack. The other is the fire giant. Also, I did end up saving bleed bolts for this phase because I'm pretty sure you can hit him anywhere and the status buildup is the same. Either way, he goes down first try. I swear, I need to stop taking naps when that melon a person is around. Godskin Duo, my favorite. Actually, believe it or not, this was one of the easier ways to fight them. That's less of a crossbow thing and more of a range thing, though. They are weak to sleep, but that's kind of pointless when the follow-up damage is so low they just shrug it off. The real star of the show is the spear talisman. See this? Everyone's favorite attack from the noble? That is considered one long attack animation, therefore, any hits to him register as a counterattack. It's not much, like really at all, but it's one of the two times in this run I can reliably count on the spear talisman's damage boost. When all's said and done, they go down on the first try. Beast Clergyman's up next. All of his ranged options are really easy to dodge, and we can even fire while airborne, something I didn't use much until now. Malekith might have paper for armor, but he does have one advantage. He's kinda noodly. Combine that with how often he jumps around and Elden Ring's hitboxes being so tight, I missed more than I'd like, but like all before him, Malekith falls on the first try. Sir Gideon Offnir, the ever annoying. You got something on your face. Gideon here is either a complete cakewalk or an annoying thorn to my side. There is no in between. For this run, he's the latter. So the first obvious issue is that he will dodge all of our attacks, but there is a nice little trick I can do with the crossbow. I can ready a shot, then simply wait for him to start an animation. Assuming he isn't slowly walking left or right, I can score a hit. It's pretty fun to do, especially when he casts Comet Azure, because then he basically just blasts the moon for a second. Thankfully, Gideon goes down on the first try, and it wasn't even close. Yep, not close at all. Godfrey, good to see ya, how's the kids? Oh, sorry about that. The first half of this fight is the same as before, except I have a bigger space to run away from him in. I was actually being really reckless here, taking shots that I knew weren't safe just because I felt like I had it in the bag. But you know what they say, pride cometh before the fall. That single grab took more than half my health. Wear armor, kids. Also, questionable hitbox game, but okay. Second try goes much better. If you're wondering why I'm using fire and magic bolts, it's because he has no resistance to fire, magic, and lightning, and actually gains a weakness to magic in phase 2. So, you know, just trying to spice it up a little bit. After taking an excessive amount of crossbow bolts straight to the dick, Horalu goes down on the second try. This is the part of the run where I have to decide if I want to do the final boss or all of the optional supers first, and this time I picked Radagon because he's first in my heart. So Angry Hammerman is neutral to fire damage, which is good considering Elden Beast is resistant to literally everything. The only issue here is Radagon is capable of catching my bolts and throwing his own back, but as long as I never attack while he's idle, that isn't a problem. He can be afflicted with rot and frostbite, but I never bothered to craft those, so here I am, just slowly chipping his health down. It takes a few dozen bolts, but going into Elden Beast, I knew I'd be fine. All of his attacks are easily avoided, with the exception being Elden Stars, but by running under his armpit, we can stay away from it for most of its duration. Can you imagine being a literal god, a force of nature itself, and some half-naked blindfolded lady with a crossbow angrily starts shooting toothpicks at you? And wins? Like, take the L, my guy. After 20 minutes, Radabeast falls, and we have beaten Elden Ring with an ordinary crossbow. But there are some other bosses I want to take care of before this challenge is officially over. Also, I now have 99 vigor, which means runes are basically worthless. I figured since I'm already able to access Moog, might as well go do him first, which means it's time to awkwardly stand around and wait for an NPC to hit me. At least he has dragon attacks, which themselves are long animations. 250 per shot. Not bad. Okay, I mean it's bad, but like, I can make it work. The worst part about this fight is just that he can heal off of knee heal. Like, it's already slow enough, why do you have to waste more time, Moog? Sure hope no other bosses have healing mechanics. Over 100 bolts later, the Lord of Blood is no more. I wanted to do Radahn next, but remembered I have never spoken to Ronnie, so up at Caria Manor, I take on Loretta. I just want to remind everyone, this is a plus 25 crossbow, and I only do that much damage. This weapon is not good. Hey, Ronnie, how's it going? No hard feelings about me pelting your mom with arrows, right? Cool, cool. Alright, now it's time for Radahn. I'm so glad this game doesn't operate on real-world physics. That man has a chest plate at least half a meter thick. There's no way my bolts would be hurting him. I guess, to be fair though, if it did use real-world physics, when he yeets himself into the stratosphere, he'd just keep going and then he wouldn't be my problem anymore. Anyway, General Radahn goes down on the first try. Next, I do something I have never done in a challenge run. I get Radahn's Great Rune. Normally, I prefer Godric's, but that is actually useless to me, and just look at that health bar. Time to take on the Lands Between's most tenacious boss, me. I took away her crossbow, and this is just a pathetic display from either side. Speaking of pathetic, Regal Ancestor Spirit. Bambi here has a weakness to fire, but also a weakness to holy, something that's exceedingly rare in this game, so I take the chance to finally use holy bolts. I don't know why I expected it to do more, to be honest. Maybe one day you'll get your time, Mr. Spirit, but today is not that day. Cool dagger that I can't use, check. Stupid statue I can use, also check. I make a quick stop to get the curse mark of death, then make my way down to Estelle. So here's a fun fact, I'm an idiot! Estelle is classified as a gravity type enemy, which means he takes extra pain from things that deal gravity damage. I thought meteor bolts did that because, you know, meteor holding up the stars, several bosses have meteor style attacks. Anyway, no, they just deal magic damage, which he is fairly resistant to. I did realize my error just before the fight because I'm passively researching the run as I'm doing it, but I'm still annoyed that I didn't get to make a cool, wow, 20 extra damage joke. Excuse me, game, would you care to explain yourself? Whatever, he isn't the problem and goes down on the first try. I wanted to take on Fortisax next, but that means I either need to go through Sewer Moog or the Valiant Gargoyles. I'm not actually sure if Moog would be there because I already fought the real one, but there is an omen down there that I do not want to mess with. So instead, here I am taking on another A-plus duo boss fight. I ended up using the Meteor Bolts here because I thought they had a weakness to magic, but they actually just resist it slightly less than the other elements. Neat. Either way, they go down no problem. Next up is Fia's Champions. Oh boy, a 5-man PvP fight when I use a weapon they are programmed to dodge. Fortunately, there is one little trick I can use here. We all know that enemies that are standing in water take increased lightning damage, but did you know if you shoot a lightning arrow into the water, it'll ripple out? Basically, for this fight, I am no longer aiming at the enemies and instead am aiming at their feet, hoping they just jump into the shockwave. Hey, if it works, it ain't stupid. Lich Dragon Fortisax, a visually imposing boss to be sure, but as I've stated many times in the past, the easiest way to win is to just stay far away from him. I guess it doesn't really work for melee though, does it? Anyway, he can't close distances quickly, and the few attacks that are gap closers are very slow and easy to dodge. Also, he takes double damage to the head, so for once in this run, it looks like I'm doing normal numbers. Nice. only 3 bosses left, and they are probably going to be the 3 hardest, which is why I saved them for last. Since I just took down one dragon, I might as well polish off the pair, meaning Placidus X, you're up next. I love the spectacle of this fight, but mechanically, nothing really happens. It's even more boring than melee, if you can believe it. Hey, Placidus X, am I being a pain in your ass?
I was trying to be cool and snipe him out of the air, but I guess I'm just not cool.
One final bolt and he goes down. Looks like it's time to go towards the Goddess of Rot. First, I so kindly take half a medallion from an old man, then it's off to see the commander. At first, I was thinking of how I would handle the encounter. It shouldn't be too hard. But then I thought, why not just cheese him?
I have full confidence I could have fought him normally and won, but I don't have many more chances to do this cheese, so why not?
He even decides to come look over at me, meaning I can get headshots more easily. How nice of him. I have found the meta.
Loretta, second verse, same as the first.
This fight is exactly the same as last time, except she has more health and more projectiles. I quickly grab the Dragon Crest Great Shield Talisman for extra protection, and it's time to take on Melania. So the obvious issue aside from everything is that she will dodge my bolts, meaning I have to play reactively. Which, to be fair, is the normal way to play. Boss does something, you dodge it, boss gets hit in the face, rinse and repeat until one of you falls over. The problem here is I don't do any damage, and she will most definitely outheal anything I do to her in one hit. Okay, no problem, we just have to no-hit her on top of doing minuscule damage. I wonder if it's making any of you anxious that I'm fighting Melania with 1.1 million runes. You also may have noticed I'm using bone bolts. That's good, because I didn't. I didn't mean to use them, I just didn't carefully check what ammo I had loaded before starting the fight. I saved the bird bolts for phase 2 because I know she would do Scarlet Aeonia, giving me plenty of time to build up bleed. Plus, she's more aggressive, so I should have more attack windows overall. And after 18 minutes of sweating bullets, she goes down. One left.
To get to Rykard, I have 2 options, either the assassination quest or through Volcano Manor.
Avid viewers will know I heavily favor the questline, but in this case, I think Bowser's Castle is the smarter option, meaning I have to fight the Godskin Noble. It's basically just the same as the duo fight. I can even shoot around the pillars for bonus counterattack damage, so that's cool.
Alright, Rykard. Pretty sure my crossbow can't fire the Serpent Hunter Spear, so it's time to give him his free acupuncture session.
Some of you might be wondering why I saved him for last, even past Melania. Well, that's because he has what I like to call a metric crap ton of health. My solution to this was simply to use the bird bolts to bleed him, and I decided to do that in phase 1 because he has this stupid attack that I hate. What I failed to account for was that he has more health in phase 2. Oops. And the cherry on this problem cake is that I never bothered to craft poison frost or rot arrows, so I literally have to just shoot darts at him for like 30,000 health. A small, microscopic silver lining is that it's pretty easy to get counterattack damage, but I mean, it doesn't really matter. Nearly 300 bolts later, Rykard falls and the challenge is over. If you have made it this far, please consider giving me a like and subscribing. It helps the channel out way more than you know, and a big, big thanks to my amazing patrons. Stay beautiful, y'all. Until next time, my friends, don't you dare go hollow.